Welcome to the beginner's guide for Wasteland 3. I'll make one huge ultimate guide in, let's say, a month from now when I'm on my second or third playthrough for the game. But for now, I want to make it easier for everyone to play on a Supreme Jerk difficulty, and I'll tell you what works in the game, what's good to start, in my personal opinion. I've spent around 10 hours in the game so far. And this game is like 90% similar to Wasteland 2, so there won't be any problems with this guide at all. Let's start. We enter with identification, and we're gonna pick a background, which is very important for your character. After checking all of the backgrounds, I believe and I decided that the Vicious Avenger is probably the most important stat in a game, because it gives penetration. Enemies tend to have a lot of armor, and this gives the most for the start. If it works on a Supreme Jerk, it will work on all other difficulties as well. All of these other backgrounds, they all provide some very, very good passive bonuses, like explosive damage bonus if you plan to play with bazookas, grenades, and similar stuff. Critical chance bonus with a Goat Killer. Crit chance is huge in this game, because crits hurt. When I say hurt, I mean hurt. I'm one-shotting enemies with my sniper build when I get a crit. Perception is amazingly good stat to have. The bigger your perception is, the more hidden stuff you'll spot. It's also my second recommendation as a background. Of course, the classic is XP gain bonus, but we're gonna talk about experience gain a bit later. Now we speak about starting weapons. Believe it or not, Wasteland 3 is balanced to perfection. It's not a mistake if you pick whatever you like here. For me personally, maybe for the start, since I know how much enemies hurt on a Supreme Jerk, this melee weapons won't work as well as ranged weapons. So be sure to invest into ranged weapon, at least for your first playthrough. My favorite one is sniper rifle. It just hurts. It has a huge arm pen. After that, assault rifles, shotguns, and submachine guns are great. Semi-auto pistol is good to switch from your sniper rifle when you run out of ammo. Attributes. This is the most important part by far. And how you should make your builds. Coordination will give you action points. Action points are probably the most important thing in the game. I'm still testing luck, but luck seems crazy good also. Not only because of huge penetration that it has, but you can also get very lucky. And when you get lucky, I mean you get extremely lucky with crits, with money, with everything. So far, I triggered luck like 5 or 6 times. And it really has huge benefits. Awareness gives perception, and as I said, perception is just huge if you want to spot hidden things. On top of all of it, it also gives you hit chance, that's extremely important, and range damage bonus, which I don't want to even discuss. Pure damage. Strength seems like the weakest attribute in the game. I doubt anyone needs strength in this game. If you position well, you don't need constitution, and strength only gives constitution. There is no item weight in this game. You can carry whatever you like, so perhaps strength is the weakest part so far. Speed, initiative. Again, it's not bad to have initiative and evasion, but if you position well and trigger those fights in the right order, you can pass without initiative in the first 10 levels or so. After that, you'll get attribute points when you level up, so you can put some into initiative. Intelligence was the most important stat by far in Wasteland 2, because it was giving you skill points when you level up. This time, it only gives you flat skill points when you invest into it. So, it's not a bad thing to have huge intelligence, especially on snipers and assault rifles, because of the high crit chance and of a critical damage multiplier, you can really, really, really hurt a lot. I'm one-shotting with my sniper right now when I crit, It's crazy. On level 3, you get like 400, 500 damage on Supreme Jerk when you crit with intelligence maxed out. But don't expect skill points out of it like in Wasteland 2. Charisma seems like the most OP stat in the game. In Wasteland 2, it was intelligence. In Wasteland 3, it's charisma. Why? When you max out charisma to maximum, you get 30% XP bonus and 10% more mission reward bonus. I believe it's very smart to max out charisma, or at least put it on every character on 6 or 8 points. You decide what you want to do, but this is definitely the most important attribute in the game for now. How would I rate attributes from most important to less important? The most important is charisma. After charisma is intelligence if you plan to deal damage. After intelligence, coordination and awareness are equally important on everyone. Speed and strength are not important at all, while luck can serve you well or it can backfire if you're unlucky. But it seems like luck is a hidden gem here in the attributes. Now we speak about skills. When you make characters, you'll get to play with two characters. One should carry a sniper, the other one should carry assault rifle or SMGs. So make sure you put one character on sniper rifles and the other one on assault rifles. Melee combat and brawling are very risky because enemies are really hurt and they're not stupid at all. You won't have a lot of chances to hit them with melee. Small arms are good to switch from a huge weapon to a pistol because they take less attribute points to shoot. Big guns, you'll get companions with big guns along the way. Do not go for them for the start. From general skills, everything is important, everything works. You'll need everything you see here. But what I recommend for the start is sneaky shit. It's quite simple, gives perception, initiative, detection time, and your sneak attack damage is brutal. First aid is equally important as sneaky shit, and everyone should have at least 1 point into first aid so you can heal. Taking more points into first aid will allow for better healing effects and reviving your companions. Animal Whisperer is a cool skill to have. It's not that important, but it's very cool to have it. Leave out explosives and weird science for late game. Exploration skills. Do not waste your points on armor modding, weapon modding, toaster repair, and survival when you start the game. You'll get your companions once you reach the headquarters, and then you're gonna pick companions that actually have those skills. What you need to start with is lockpick, nerd stuff, and mechanics. Make sure that one of your characters has lockpick and the other one nerd stuff or mechanics, or the other way around. It's your choice. But have in mind these three are the most important among all of this for the start. No matter the difficulty, I recommend them for Supreme Jerk, so it's gonna work on every difficulty. Social skills. One of your character should have leadership maxed out as soon as possible. It's extremely important and it's the best skill in the game. Your main character should have kiss ass, the other main character should have hard ass. Leave barter for later on. Now we speak about quirks. All quirks, to be honest, look very interesting, but I want to give you the quirks that don't have that many negatives in the game and the quirks you can actually profit from. One of those quirks is Prospector, because you'll occasionally dig out gold nuggets, which means money. Money means power. If you've picked your main class to go with assault rifle or even better, a sniper, this is definitely a quirk you want to look into. Poindexter is bloody great. You don't need constitution, and that's what the game takes away from you. Your sniper will remain far away and shoot from afar, and you'll always get a bonus skill point on every second level up. Great trade-off. Another huge trade-off is Sadomasochist. It's fucking hilarious how good this thing is on a sniper. It's very simple. You receive 33% more damage, but you're gonna deal 33% more damage. Imagine a sniper with huge intelligence, which raises crit multiplier and crit chance with additional 33% damage. Those are easy crits on level 3 or 4 from 500. This is how I play right now. I highly recommend sadomasochist on a sniper. It's amazing how good it is. Most of the quirks you see here are oriented towards melee. And I said, playing with a melee in a game where everyone shoots at you is a huge risk. Have that in mind. Now we speak about a few tips and tricks for combat and what you should do and how you should position, because this game is everything about positioning. So let's begin. When you click space, you mark all of your squad mates or detach them. Detach them before starting the fight. Once they're detached, you pick them up one by one, put them into cover, and you're gonna crouch down or press number 3. Now they're in cover, and then you can open and shoot at the enemies from a safe zone. Make sure you put everyone in cover, and then use your highest damage dealer to open up a fight. In order to use consumables, for example, medic packs, you'll need first aid, help your squad mates. You're gonna use your quick items, or better to say healings, here. When precision strikes are shining blue here, make sure to use them and disable enemies' legs, arms, head, or torso. Usually, torso breaks armor, head makes shock or stun. Legs, they cannot run towards you. It's very good using it on melee classes. And arms will disable weapons, in most cases. Do not forget to use your ranger's abilities on a ranger star here. Perks and how we should use perks. Listen, after watching perks for at least 30 minutes or so, I realized one thing. Most of the perks, if not all of the perks, are extremely useful. So no matter what you take, you won't make a mistake. The only mistake you can make is if you go with constitution. Spending a perk point in constitution is a waste of perk, because if you position well, you won't worry that much about your HP now, will you? Just make sure your character has leadership and take the first perk available from leadership once you gain a perk point. During combat, you will be able to switch your weapons and items in your quick slots. For example, you can equip grenades and you won't lose action points. Do it often, switch, and find the best way to deal with your opponents. I repeat, you won't lose action points. Compared to previous CRPGs and all other Wastelands and Fallout, this game doesn't have inventory pages, so pile those items up as much as you like. I fucking love it. Nothing stops you from piling up. It's a great addition. When I just remember how Ammo had inventory weight, huge inventory weight in Wasteland 2. This is such a good news that Ammo and all other items are without weight now. You can play freely and don't lose time at all on organizing your inventory. Inventory is shared, so joy. Alright, that would be a very short beginner's guide. As I said, the game seems balanced so freaking well. You won't make a mistake no matter what you choose. Everything is valid. I gave you the best options for the start. Sniper, assault rifles, what you need from skills, what are the good quirks, what are the good perks. Now you decide how you want to play. I won't force any build on you when I make an ultimate guide for this game. It's gonna be after my second or third playthrough, once I learn every aspect of the game and everything there is. And then we can speak more seriously about the game. For now, this is a very good start. It works for me on a Supreme Jerk. It will work for you on every difficulty available. I thank you all for watching. And I'll be seeing you very soon on the Ultimate Guide.